This is Slindon College, a boys' boarding school set in the rolling countryside of Hampshire.
Come on, boys. Now, I've got your homework. I'll just go over them rather quickly. Turn to page 39. Question 1 and 2 you have to do. Flynn, you made a reasonable effort with what you've done.
It's just another Tuesday for boys in Mr. Lee Judson's science class. Homework wasn't in on time. Questions haven't been answered properly.
Geoffrey, now you've done a fair effort here, if I remember right. You've got nearly full marks. Your work's improving no end.
Right, what have we got for today? French history, maths, science, horse racing? Horse racing? This I've got to see for myself.
I had a right to be surprised because although this looks like an ordinary school with the sort of classes and activities you'd find in any other school, it actually has on its premises a racing stable where some of the country's top horses are trained and looked after by the boys themselves. One of the horses, Zipperib, is racing tomorrow and the boys are working hard getting everything ready for the big day.
How many of the boys at the school actually ride the horses?
About five of them.
So there's five sort of trainee jockeys?
Yes.
Any chance of talking to Glenn?
Yeah. Glenn, can you come over here?
What does it feel like to be sitting up there on a racing horse? Is it anything at all like riding a normal horse?
They're more lively, hard control, and you don't have to kick them, you have to hold them back.
Hold them back?
Yeah.
Are you strong enough to do that?
Well, this one doesn't pull much, so I'm okay on this one.
This is the big day. The race meeting is at Fontwell Park, a relatively small event compared to, say, next month's derby at Epsom or Ascot. It's about 2 miles from the school, so the boys are here today to watch their horse. You can see all the frantic activity going on before the race. The bookies are hard at work taking bets. In Britain, a staggering £3,500 million is spent on horse gambling every year. And there's Zipperib, being led round the parade ring just before the start of the race. He's a four-year-old chestnut, and most of his life he's run on the flat and done very well. Now the school are trying him over the hurdles, and poor old Zipperib's finding the transition rather difficult. I found the boys on the racetrack, and we watched the horses coming up to the starting post. Zipperib's jockey is wearing light blue with red diamonds, white sleeves and a white cap. Zipperib has run five times for the school so far, with rather erratic results, ranging from second to last. Despite the boys not being optimistic about his chances, they reckoned he'd come in last, he started off well, and we were amazed that after the first lap he was well up front. Then suddenly, there he was amongst the leaders. Fourth place, not bad. I rushed off to give Zipperib a pat of congratulations before he was taken back to school.
Steaming so much, isn't it? Yeah. You're pleased with that result?
Yeah.
Oh, that's fantastic. What a clever boy.
Not as good as at Clampton, but he's
next time.
Yeah.
Next time.